Hello there and welcome to this PlayStation development tutorial. In this episode we will be converting these sprites into a format the PlayStation can understand the manual way. The previous time we did this we did it using a tool that just did it automatically, but before we get into stuff like CD streaming we need to understand how this actually works and how you can do it the manual way. So to convert this to a TIM file or a TIM file that the PlayStation can understand, we can use a tool in PSYQ called the TIM tool, and it's located in your PSYQ folder in the bin folder, and it's just called TIM tool. And let's open it up. So here we have it, the TIM tool, and we need to get our images into this. So these are just at my desktop right now. So we can just say import image files, and let's go to my desktop. It's right here, and here we have the images. Now these are the settings that we want to use, or the default settings. That these, all of these can be changed again later, but what we want to use is 4-bit depth. Like I like to use that because then you can do more with the memory of the PlayStation, because you don't have that many colors to keep. But you can use whatever you want here. If you want better colors, you can do that. But I'll say stick with 4-bit. This is the color lookup table. I will show you what that is later. And this is just the location of the image. So I'm just gonna leave all of this for the defaults. This is the transparency, so you can play around with these depending on what you want. If you want to cut out the black areas here on this image, or like the gray areas here, like do that, you can play around with these. We're just going to use set for black. This will make the black color semi-transparent. So in this image we will have semi-transparency around this black area here, and probably also in the nose. So yeah, you should probably tweak your sprites a bit and have these things in mind if you want to use transparency, and I guess all games do that to a degree. So yeah, let's import these. And you see here already we have the TIM files, but they are not ready yet. So this is a representation of the memory in the PlayStation. And you can drag the sprites around. This you see right here is the game screen in many games. And this right here is the buffer of the game screen. That's what's going to be drawn next on the screen. Or where we draw before, it's flipped to this area. We can see that if we open up NoCache. There's an example that I've been playing around with. Let me just open up the right NoCache. There we go. This is just an example I've been playing around with, and you can see here in NoCache, if you go to the VRAM or GPU viewer, you can see right here what's going on. Now this area from here to here is the memory of the GPU, or the frame buffer that's called. And to the left here you see this is the current screen, and this is what's going to be drawn next, and they are the same because yeah, it's not updating that slowly. It's going pretty fast when we draw, and there's not a lot to draw overall. So yeah, these mostly look the same, and we can see here that we have the two sprites that we loaded in here, the face and the PlayStation. And the reason why they look distorted is that the colors that these use are not directly placed here. The colors are actually down here. You can see that these little dots right here, that those are the colors used for reference for these, so they know which colors they are. And that's the color lookup table, or the CLUT as it's called. That's located down here. So if we want to organize this, and we want to have a lot of sprites in our game, we can use all of these to fill up with sprites. And sometimes you might hit a roadblock. Well, this is filled up. When that's when CD streaming comes in, because with CD streaming, you might have two sprites that are not in the same loaded at the same time. Like if you have two levels, you want to only load one of them at the same time. So in that case, we could actually place these on top of each other, because then they wouldn't interfere, and we could just like use them one at a time. But if you want to use them both at the same time, they should be like at a separate spot. So here we can set the color lookup table where it's going to be located. I like to have it down here. So that is 960 and 256. And for the PlayStation, or for the crash image, we can do the same. So that is 960. But instead of 256, let's just increment by one and say 257, because then it will be right below. And once you're done with all your sprites for this project, you can save the project if you want, or just create a new project first, I guess. And you want to say save the modified TIM files. So now these are actually ready to be used. What my previous tool did is that it converted these files into a header file, and that allows you to not use CD streaming and just load them directly into memory. So in the next episode, we're going to be working with these files along with some other files and try to load them from a CD and free them and load some other ones, so that you can use the space of the CD instead of using the space of the GPU. And by that, you can have a lot of textures. Like the CD has, I think it's 700 megabytes of size that you can utilize. And this has only 2 megabytes. So you can do a lot more, obviously. So yeah, that's it. Hope this didn't get too complicated. Just comment below if you're in doubt about anything, or I might have said something wrong. You can also correct me. So thank you for watching. See you in the next episode. And stay tuned.